Hi friends, welcome to our channel Civil Estimation. Today we will discuss about how to calculate the manpower productivities and its factor. It is very important to any estimation engineer to prepare the tender. That's why we have prepared here one master table for all the productivities for various kind of activities under different head groups like earthworks, concreting works, farm work, reinforcing steel, grouting works, then structural steel works, then waterproofing works, masonry works, plastering works, roof and wall cladding sheeting works, finishes like floor finishes, wall finishes, skirting, ceiling finishes, and doors and windows only installation, pipelines, and various miscellaneous activities and the subcontract activities. Apart of that one, we have prepared one major master productivity table to calculate the direct manpower cost for any project. This is the project. These are the full forms of the mason, carpenter, steel fitter, painter, structural steel fitter, other skilled like plumber, something like that, then helpers, unskilled persons. This is the currency AED, sector oil and gas, working hours 8 hours per day, total productivity factor 0.68. That we will discuss in detail. This is very important. I will how we arrived this 0.65, on what classification and what percentage efficiency we have arrived this 0.65. I will explain in detail. And this whatever considered here manpower rates, that is inclusive all, excluding the food and accommodation and site transportation, including all means their salary, normal OT, minimum OT, 2 hours, their visa, air ticket, medical charges, visa charges, and recruitment agency charges, so insurance charges, their end of service benefits like leave, salary, gratuity, everything, consider all those things, excluding the food and accommodation, it is coming mason 91 AED. Similarly, helper also it is coming 75. Same rates only we considered here. Mason 90. Similarly, carpenter, steel fitter, painter, and structural steel fitter, other skilled and helper 75. So part of that is the and food and accommodation we will consider separately as part of our indirect cost. So based on this sheet, how many man days, how many man months are coming and totally. Based on quantity, finally we will arrive here how many total man days. If you consider 26 days per month, how many man months, skilled, unskilled, how much, like that. Based on that, we can consider here skilled, unskilled workers, total man months, and what will be the mandatory food and accommodation charge per month, like that we can calculate. Similarly, equipment also for transportation purpose, 65 seat bus, 35 seat bus, and pickups, 25-seater bus, like that. Based on that, number of required manpower only per month, how much it is coming based on this productivity schedule, and we will prepare the one histogram. Based on that histogram and the schedule, we will assume the equipment. That's why in this rates we have not taken any food and accommodation and the site transportation charges. So we'll go to the table, serial number. This is BOQ item description, BOQ quantity, unit of measurement, ideal productivity per day. Means if your conditions are normal, means everything is likely a condition. So what will be the productivity for that? In based on that ideal productivity, we need to apply the factors. Then we will arrive the unit rate cost, required manpowers in numbers. Mason, for example, excavation, manual, soil, less than 2 cubic meter depth, to do 1 cubic meter of BOQ quantity, to do 1 cubic meter, one helper can do the 2 cubic meters per day, that is the productivity per day. This is the numbers, one number. Then man days, how many man days are required? Suppose 1 cubic meter can do, one person can do 2 cubic meter, total quantity is 1 cubic meter. How many days are required? 0.5 only, but here 0.8 came. Why? Your factor applied 0.65, that is the reason 0.8 came. Suppose if it is factor is 1 automatically it will come 0.5. That is the reason this came 0.8. Then these are the man days, like each category wise we will get, then multiplied by the all the skilled man days multiplied by corresponding unit rate, we will get the total skilled amount. Similarly, helper amount, unskilled, total man days is required multiplied by the rate. Then add that one skilled and unskilled, this is the total amount. Then unit rate is total amount divided by the BOQ quantity. Like that we need to arrive at the unit rate. This unit rate we want to consider in this BOQ. For example, excavation up to 2 cubic meter. What is the quantity? 1719 cubic meter. What is the unit rate? 5789. That came from here only. Like that we have considered. If you want to see, apply the BOQ quantity also here. What is that quantity? 1791. To do the 1791 cubic meters of earthwork, we need 1377 man days of the helpers with 0.65 factor, and with these are the rates 75 AED per day. Then it is coming total amount 10303298. Unit rate is, see, total amount divided by cubic meter 58. See, this is also 103298, and BOQ also same 103298 total amount. So any tender also we want to estimate like this. After finalizing the BOQ, if it is lump sum, we need to prepare the, we need to generate the BOQ based on the given drawings, specifications, and tender bulletin, so tender clarifications. Then each activity we need to bifurcate it into each unit rate. What is the labor material component, labor component, plant, any subcontract activities there, any adjustments, total like that. Then total amount. Same with this quantity multiplied by this unit rate each factor, we will get the total amount for the corresponding material, labor, plant, subcontract, adjustment total like that. So like this we need to provide the total manpower productivities like this. For that we have prepared this very important plan, master table schedule. And then we will go to this, how we arrived at this 0.65. Any all the civil engineering projects based on the productivity of manpower and equipment to achieve good results. So based on that productivity is only we need to arrive at the total direct cost for a particular project. In my previous videos, if you look into that one, I gave all the construction equipment productivities, like how we are discussing about the manpower equipments. Similarly, I made several videos for the equipment productivities, like excavator, shovel, dumper, dozer, grader, roller. Every equipment we have calculated the separate video for the equipment productivities. Now we go to that one. Estimating the correct productivity is probably the most important decision for the estimation engineer. Suppose if you ask any estimation engineer what will be the labor rate for the 200 mm thick solid block masonry per square meter. Suppose if he say $10, 10 dirham, 20 dirham, 30 dirham per square meter, then if we ask on what basis, if you said like this, if we say based on my previous project data, then that is not correct. Then he is not a experienced estimation engineer. If it is experienced estimation engineer, he will say to do the 200 mm thick solid block masonry, one person, one mason, one helper can do this many square meters per day. So mason rate this much, helper rate this much per day. So both the rate per day rate divided by the productivity, we will get the unit rate. Like that he will say. The experienced estimator will say like that. The purpose, for that purpose we have prepared this video to useful for every estimation engineer in a tender. Not only this year, this video will be useful for many years, coming 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, because we are talking about the productivity only. Just you need to calculate the that performance productivity factor for each and every project based on your country, based on your project condition, that's all. After a comparison of many projects constructed under varied conditions, so we have found that the production elements can be grouped into 6 classifications. And that percentage can be classified into 5 different categories. So after based on my total entire 25 years of experience and worked for different companies, multinational companies and multinational exposure, then with the help of the several books we have classified it the product this production categories are general economy, project supervision, labor relations, job conditions, equipment, weather. Again, the productivity efficiency we have taken as grouped into the, if it is very low 10 to 20, the percentage range we have decided low 41 to 60, average 61 to 80, very good 81 to 90, excellent 91 to 80. So these are the classification of the production factors. So this is the productivity efficiency percentage range. Based on this, we have evaluated and analyzed each and every these six conditions. We will go in detail general economy. If any country GDP is good, the country GDP is going forwarding, increasing every day. So not every infrastructure or building projects, any projects is going well. In that case, all the manpower is engaged in the projects. So if any new projects is there, we will not get the experienced manpower in that case. So we need to take the freshers and give the experience and give the training and utilize for our project. So it will take time, then our project will not get correct productivity efficiency. That's why in that case, because of this economic growth is good, we will get only the 75% of efficiency, because of getting the manpower is very difficult. Then similarly, project supervision. What is the caliber of our supervision? How we can manage this project? Or we have previous experience in similar kind of projects. How we will get this mentor? How we can able to pay the salaries based on the market or par with the market? Like this, we want to analyze this under this classification, project supervision, based on the these factors, experience, supply, and how much we are able to pay. Further, after analyzing that, we arrived at that one 70% of efficiency for that this project supervision. Then come to the labor conditions. Our organization have any good relations, labor relation men? Suppose we have any good, well-trained foremen and judge hands to handle the various categories of the skilled and unskilled manpower. This project labor conditions also depends on the factors, experience, supply, and pay. Depends on that one. And then for our example, let us say that for a project we found that our labor relations to be fair, but feel that they could be a little better, and that we will have to based on partially on travelers. Since this is the case, we arrive at an efficiency rate of 65% of this element. Then job conditions, where we are going to execute this project. What is the job condition? Is there in a brownfield or greenfield? Is there any underground facilities are there? How is the soil condition? Whether it is hard, loose, any muddy condition, whether the rainwater is easily drained off, or we need to do any pumping, something like that. So the most important items to analyze this job condition are scope of work, site condition, material procurement, manual and mechanized operations. Whether it is a manual job or mechanized job, material procurement, how we can procure the material in time, or based on those factors, this will happen and this will depend. For our example, let us say that the project we are estimating is a completely new plant, and that we have ample time to complete the project, but the site location is low and muddy. Therefore, after evaluation, we estimate the product range is 60%. Then find equipment. So what are the equipment we are having? That required project equipment, are we having by in-house, or we need to engage, we need to get it from the rental agencies? Suppose if we are having equipment, what is the condition of that equipment, whether it is in good condition or maybe it requires some maintenance and repair? The main items to study under these elements are the usability of equipment, condition of equipment, and maintenance repair of the equipment. Every estimator should know that what type of equipment his company is having, as well as what kind of the condition of that equipment. If equipment is up and on a rental basis, then the estimator should know the agency he intends to use, to whether they will finish good equipment and maintenance. So after careful evaluation, for example, that our company equipment is in very good shape, that we have an ample supply to draw from, we have averaged the mechanics, and we estimate a productivity percentage range of is 60-70%. Then finally, the weather condition. What does the weather condition in the project where we are going to execute in? Whether it is rainy or snow, cold or hot. For that, the following items we need to check to analyze that condition. Previous weather reports, rain or snow or sandstorm conditions, hot and cold conditions. For our example, let us assume that the weather is about half good and half bad. During the period that our project is to be constructed, we must then assume a productivity range of 50% for this element. After arriving all the classifications of different activities, then we arrive at the productivity percentage. For a general economy, 75%, project supervision 70%, lab relation 65%, job condition 60%, equipment 70%, weather condition 50%. Total is 390%. Then this divided by the total, how many classifications? 6 classifications. Total percentage divided by the classification, we will get the 65%. This is the overall productivity factor of this project after careful evaluation and analyzing the condition. The same 65 only we applied here. That is the reason this is very important to consider this productivity factor. Based on this factor only, this number of days and unit rate will be dependent. Suppose if it is not properly analyzed and not looking to these activities, suppose the productivity factor we have taken 1. See, now with this factor, unit rate is coming 58 per cubic meter. If it is 1, how much it is coming? See, 38 dirham per cubic meter came. Almost 40% reduction is there. If we consider like this, but we may get job, but we may definitely lose the money from our owner. So to avoid that one, we need to properly evaluate all these factors and consider these factors. Now we'll go by earthworks, each and every activity. This earthworks also we have again further divided into manual excavation, machine excavation, and backfilling by manual, backfilling by machine. Then we'll go one activity, earthwork excavation by manual. Soil type is less than 2 meter depth of excavation. One helper can do 2 cubic meter per day. Like that, we need to arrive the unit rate. Then soil 2 to 4. One helper can do 1.25 cubic meter. Then what will be the unit rate? 92 AED per cubic meter. And then trenches, soil by manual 2 to 4. One helper can do per day 1.75 cubic meter. Then the unit rate will be 66 AED per cubic meter. Then weak rock, less than 3 meter depth of excavation. One helper can do 1 cubic meter in a day. And then 115 AED per cubic meter. Like that, we need to calculate. Here it is coming here based on that productivity. We will calculate like this. Because of this 1 cubic meter per day, 1 cubic total, applying the 0.63 factor, 1.5 man day is required. Then man day rate is 975, so 115. 115 total amount. 115 total amount. Then total amount divided by total quantity, pivot quantity 1. So unit rate is 115. Then slit trenches, 1 meter by 1 meter by 1.5 meter deep. One person can do 3 cubic meter per day. Then 3 meter deep, one person can do 2 cubic meter per day. So like this we need to arrive. Compaction of the excavated surface. One helper can do 15 square meter per day. Then removal of the loose gravel and keep it aside before the trench excavation. So that is 20 square meter one helper can do in a day. Then machine excavation, general excavation, wide area like site preparation works. For every 150 cubic meter of machine excavation work, we need one helper. Similarly, foundations, so soil less than 2, every 75 cubic meter, one helper. What is the rate? 2 AED per cubic meter. Then 2 to 4 meter, 50 cubic meter per day, one helper is required. Then 4 to 6, every 40 cubic meter, one helper we need to arranging. Then the rate 380 per cubic meter. Like that, we crack for every 15 cubic meter one. Then the soil trenches every 50 cubic meter one helper. Soil trenches 2 to 4. This is also same as that one. And we crack 2 to 4, 15 cubic meter one. We crack 4 to 6, 8 cubic meter one helper is required. Then cut and fill every 60 cubic meter one helper is required. Like that. Backfilling by manual. Backfill whether it is purchased soil or the excavated soil, and we will get the material near to the fill it to the, by the dumpers and the shovel excavators. Then we will spread it and layer by layer as per our specification to do that one. For the compaction layer spreading, one helper can do 4 cubic meters per day. So 29 AED per cubic meter is coming. Then sand filling in the trenches for the cable trenches and pipeline trenches to fill that one, 5 cubic meter per day, one helper can give. Similarly, by machine, backfilling by machine in wide area, every 500 meters, cubic meter one foundations, every 50 cubic meter one helper with foundation 25, then gutch bund formation for the pipeline, gas pipeline, gutch bund formation, gutch top road, gravel compaction, gutch compaction, slope production, 100 mm thick, these are the productivities we have taken. So I will stop here. You can take the print out this here, and you can prepare your Excel sheet like this. So take this snapshot here up to here, then I will stop here up to here, then backfilling by machine. Take this snapshot here, so like this. Like this we need to arrive the total, suppose the 1791, suppose maybe 100,000 also, 100,000 cubic meter also, 100,000 cubic meter also, it is coming, unit rate is same, amount is coming different. So accordingly, number of man days also will increase. See here, total this many man days. Every month, 26 days you take, this many total man months. Suppose for this earth work to do only 3 months time is required. So we need 993, average 997 headcount is required every month. If to do the this work, 100,000 of cubic meters of the manual earth work. Like that we need to prepare the total manpower productivities and the manpower how many days are required. In hope this is useful for everybody. Thank you very much.